Good morning, students. Our today's topic is models of organization behavior. Okay. Now, since this is the topic of organization behavior, let us also discuss that what is organization behavior. We can say that it is a field of study that investigates that how individuals, groups, and structure affect and are affected by behavior within the organization. Since we are talking about the models of organization, the basic purpose of model development is to understand the human behavior in the organization, prediction and control of human behavior. And these models also illustrate the goals, parameters, and factors of organization behavior. And they also describe the abstraction of reality, simplifies the representation of the real world phenomenon. Now, these models also explain the behavior at individual, group, and at the organizational levels. Although there are four models of organization behavior, but here we will be studying five models of organization. So, students, the first model is the autocratic model. Now, this model depends on the power of the boss. Over here, the motto is might is right. Those who are in command must have the power to demand. You do this or else, meaning those who do not follow the orders will be penalized. In the autocratic environment, the managerial orientation is official authority. The employee orientation is obedience to the boss, not the respect for him. The psychological result for employees is dependence on the boss, whose power to hire, fire, and perspire them is almost absolute. The employee's needs must satisfy subsistence needs of themselves and their families. Most of the employees give minimum performance because of such in the organization. So finally, we can say the main features of this model are only the management decides what is right and what is wrong. There is an obedient orientation of employees towards their bosses. And we can also say that it is a useful approach because the autocratic model was an acceptable approach to guide managerial behavior when there were no well-known alternatives, and it still can be useful under some conditions where situations are different. Now, the second model is the custodial model. This model depends on the economic resources, or we can say the rewards. The resulting managerial orientation is towards money to pay wages and benefits. And since the employees' physical needs are already reasonably met, the employer looks to security needs as a motivating force. If an organization does not have the wealth to provide pensions and pay other benefits, it cannot follow a custodial approach. A custodial approach leads to employee dependence on an organization. The employees are satisfied and happy, but they are not strongly motivated, so they give only passive cooperation. Now, the main features of this model are the employee dependence is on the organization rather than being dependent on their bosses. Such kind of model emphasizes on the rewards and promotes the employee satisfaction. Now, the third model is the supportive model. The supportive model has its origin in the principles of supportive relationship and depends on leadership instead of authority or economic rewards. The management assumes that workers are not by nature passive and resist to organizational needs, but they are made so by an inadequately supportive climate at the work, which is very right. Through leadership, management provides a climate to help employees to grow and accomplish. Management's orientation, therefore, is to support the employees' job performance. The workers feel a sense of participation and takes involvement in the organization and are more concerned about higher level needs like affiliation, esteem. And the employees say we instead of they when referring to the organization. The main features of this model are: one, the supports employee job performance. It supports the employee job performance. The management's lifestyle reflects the support. Means the supportive behavior is not a kind of behavior that requires money. Rather, it is a part of management's lifestyle at work, reflected in the way that it deals with the other people. The manager's role is of helping employees to solve their problems and accomplish their work. It creates the sense of participation. And last, there's a limited application. Now, why this? Because this model has been found to be effective in affluent countries where workers are more concerned about their higher level needs like affiliation and esteem. This model has a limited application under Indian conditions because a vast majority of operative workers are still working for the satisfaction of their physiological and security needs. We are still concerned about our daily breads, right? So it has a limited application in the Indian, probably in the Indian perspective. Now, another model is collegial model. We can say that it is the useful extension of the supportive model. And the term collegial relates to a body of persons having common purpose. Now, the collegial model depends on the management's building a feeling of partnership with employees. The result is that employees feel needed and very useful. They feel that managers are contributing also, and it is easy to accept and respect their roles in the organization. Managers are seen as joint contributors rather than their bosses. The managerial orientation under the collegial model is teamwork. So the main focus over here is on the teamwork, and the management is a coach that builds a better team. The employees are self-disciplined and concerned with self-actualization needs, which lead to a moderate enthusiasm in the. We can say that it is a useful extension of collegial model. It creates the favorable working environment, fosters, that means enhances the teamwork and fulfillment of employees. Means in this kind of environment, employees normally feel some degree of fulfillment, worthwhile contribution and self-actualization, even though the amount may be the modest in some situations. This self-actualization will lead to a moderate enthusiasm in the performance. Last model is the systems model. Under this model, the managers try to convey to each other or each worker that you are an important part of the whole system and we really care about you. They show the care, that they care about their employees. Teamwork is essential to achieve a better product or service for local community and society at large. And they also say that we will make every effort to make products that are environmental friendly. That means they also take care of CSR. This helps self-motivation of employees. Over here, the role of manager becomes one facilitating employee accomplishment through a variety of actions. Now, such kind of actions that we are talking about is support employees' commitment for short and long-term goals, coaching individuals and groups in appropriate skills and behaviors, model and foster self-esteem, show genuine concern and empathy for the employees, offer timely and acceptable feedback, and also help the individuals to identify and confront issues in the ethical ways. As we know that ethics are the basis of any business. So here you can see that there's a comparison chart between different models. There are certain bases which have been decided, and on these bases we have compared, I have compared the different types of models over here. So the basis of a model over here in autocratic is power, custodial, economic, leadership. You can see the spelling is wrong, so I'll just take care of it. Collegial, partnership, and systems. You can say trust, community, understanding. Managerial orientation is authority, money, support, teamwork, and caring, compassion. Employee orientation is obedience, security, benefits, job performance, responsible behavior, and psychological ownership. And employee psychological results. In autocratic, it's dependence on the boss, dependence on the organization in custodial, participation in supportive, self-discipline in collegial, and self-motivation in systems. Employee needs met are subsistence, security, status and recognition, self-actualization, and the wide range of needs that are met in the systems model. Now, if we go for the performance result, it's minimum in autocratic. Passive cooperation is there in custodial model. Awakened drives are there in supportive model. Moderate enthusiasm and passion in the collegial model, and passion, commitment, organization goals in systems model, because everything is so good, you can see over here in systems model. Now, we can take the examples like defense team. We can take as example of the autocratic model. Any business, rather I should say a garment factory, which I have taken the example, software firm for the supportive model, social organization for the collegial model, and some other corporate firms which take care of the employees. We can say like Tata is one of the very good example. So thank you, students, and hope you will enjoy these slides. And I'll come up with another lecture regarding any other topic of this subject. Thank you so much.